I get asked this all the time. They say, what's your favorite beverage? What's your beverage of choice? What's your, you know, what's your favorite drink? Because you never talk about the things that you drink. Never, ever. You never do. So I decided to take it upon myself to let you know that I drink Chicken Express Sweet Tea. My favorite beverage of choice. Even better than the old Dr. Pepper. Because Dr. Peppers you can find everywhere. But here, got Chicken Express Sweet Tea. I put it in my red cup. Oh, that stuff is so good. Oh my gosh. Oh, that was great. Oh man, you don't understand how great that was. Yeah, I've been looking around on Facebook, seeing truckers having marital problems. And I guess they think the best thing to do is get a divorce. And I think that's sad, really. I mean, come on, man. Let's tighten it up a little bit. Let's get after it. Is trucking hard on a marriage? I mean, yeah, it's hard, really, at first, especially. Because it takes a little time to adapt. You have one of those 9-to-5 jobs. You know, and what have you, and you do that for years, and then you go out trucking, and if you got a really bad relationship to begin with, then yeah, your marriage is bound to fail. But if you have two individuals that are committed to each other, it don't matter what you do. You can be out here on the road forever, and it don't matter what, your marriage will stay strong. There's going to be ways to communicate. I mean, now it's freaking 2014, and how can you, I mean, you got all these ways to see in your better half. When I started, didn't have a cell phone or anything, and when you went to a truck stop to go talk to your wife because you had a calling card and you only had so many minutes on it, so you had to be real quick, that way you can serve those minutes. Besides that, there was a line waiting for a phone behind you, and only at Flying J's did they have the closets where you could walk in and have some privacy. As TAs and Petros, they would have their, like, a little area, like a cubicle and stuff, but other people, you can hear other people's conversations, so a lot of that stuff wasn't private that you're saying, so you really had to watch what you're talking about. Like I said, you're being rushed. So now it's a lot easier because you got cell phones, you got Skype, you got Facebook, you got all these ways to sit there and communicate. It's a lot easier now. It's easy for me to say that, though, because my wife and I are really used to, you know, what I do for a living. You know, so she's strong at the house. She's a strong lady. She's strong mother. And I, you know, you gotta have a mental toughness as a driver as well to be away. So when I get that question, say, is it hard on a relationship? Well, you have to ask yourself, how is your relationship? Because if you're having marital issues before you get into trucking, trucking's not going to help. That sure isn't. If there's any kind of trust issues whatsoever, trucking will magnify those issues for sure. And, you know, so when I get people ask me, should I go trucking? Will it hurt? Well, you know what? Go trucking, because your relationship's gonna suck anyway. But like I said, it's all about your relationship. If you got the trust, and if you can't trust your spouse on the road, what's, you know, you really got some relationship issues, because don't blame it on trucking. That's what I always hear. They blame it on trucking. You need to blame it on your actual relationship. You need to improve that. And, you know, and getting to the divorce is not the be-all, end-all. You can get away from all that stuff. You got to look to the point where, and I don't want to sound like a Dr. Phil or whatever, but you kind of got to look back and say, hey, what drew us together? You know, and sometimes you got to maybe just take yourself back to that time, what drew you and your spouse together. So, all right, that's my Dr. Phil moment. Chicken Express sweet tea for you. listen to all that noise, man. Unbelievable. So, things kind of messed up. I got four drops today, and just zigzagging all over the place. Didn't make any sense. This used to be a normal run where we'd start on the west side of town and work our way to the east side of town. Now you're starting on the east side of town, going to the west side of town, go back to the east side of town, and end on the west side of town. What the crap is going on with this freaking routing? Oh my goodness. So, anyways, it is what it is. So, you know, when you got multiple drops, and they're only an hour apiece at rush, you know, hour apart at rush hour, there's no time for, you know, anything, you know, like, you know, say if you had to wait at a store, your day's screwed. And I had to wait, stop one, I had to wait, stop two, I had to wait. Stop three was good. This one, you already said, well, you're running late, you know. Well, because, you know, I'm zigzagging all over across town in rush hour Houston. What do you expect? And he understood. He, you know, he knows me. I've delivered here so many times. He knows I'm always early. So if I'm late, there's a good reason why. So anyways, we'll still do it. Tomorrow, I got to head back to Dallas and do a local tomorrow and then do Oklahoma City on Friday. You know, we're a little short-handed because, you know, I got vacations and stuff like that going on. So, I'm going to be late all day tomorrow. I should catch up on Friday, but that'll probably make me getting home on Saturday. When I get home on Saturday, I'm not a happy camper. And I told him that, you know, he understood, but I'll take one for the team. That's for Dave, I'm sure. Yeah, you do what you do. I hope you can hear me. All this traffic is Interstate 10 right over here. I mean, look at this mess. You know, this is the intersection of, this is Fry Road right here. There's I-10 right there. And I mean, just lots and lots of freaking people. Go home already. It's like 8 o'clock. 8:30, man. Go home. Look at this. Look at this. Even more over here. Goodness gracious alive. It's a hot son of a gun out here. You know? Look at this.
Oh, sweating.
You know? It's real humid. You know, it's more humid than it is, you know, like hot degree, you know, temperature hot. But it's freaking uncomfortable as all get out, I'll tell you that. So, there's a little breeze right there. Come on, breeze. Come on, breeze. Come on. Anyways, that's all I got for y'all. Hopefully y'all got something out of this about the relationships out here on the road. And you got to go through what a little bit I go through out here. So, take you a little journey on what I do. Of course, I do that here all the time. So, hope you enjoyed it. Watch next time, and I'll say something really interesting. So, don't forget, Truckers Against Cancer on GoFundMe.com. Just search it up. I'll have a link on down below in the description. Check that out. Help my friend Marty Godfrey, KF5IXZ, if you choose, if you so choose. $5, man, you know, that means the world. It really does. Because if so many people put in $5, and, you know, it helped them out, you know, and that's what truckers do. We help people out, right? Isn't that what we do? We help? Hell? Next video, I'm going to define the word goal. 73.